European Union, how the formation of European Union started is pretty interesting. So after the 1945, which was the end of the Second World War, we had seen that the Cold War started, the support from US started, and there was an economic revival in the European nations. This was laid down under the Marshall Plan, but the idea was to bring in a sense of security among the nations. As a result, NATO was established, and this NATO aimed at providing collective security. However, with the development, we had seen that the nations of Western Europe started to get into alliance with the regions of Eastern Europe, and under this, there was a OEEC formation that took place, which was Organization for European Economic Cooperation, and the idea was to cooperate mainly on the trade and commerce. So it started with the conceptualization of Council of Europe back in 1949, which was predominantly a political cooperation. Later on, European Economic Community was built up in 1959, and this was an economic cooperation. There was creation of European Parliament that started, and finally the establishment of European Union. Now this establishment of European Union was a summation of economic cooperation as well as political cooperation together. So European Union led to the political cooperation and economic cooperation. It was not just the political and economic cooperation, but also there was cooperation on the front of foreign security, policy making. So there were numerous aspects that were taken into account. Single currency, single national anthem was propounded under European Union. So if we talk about the highlights, as we said, it was predominantly a cooperation in terms of economic cooperation, political cooperation. There was no constitution that was formed, but despite that there was no constitution, it had its own flag, its own national anthem, the common currency in the name of euro, the common visa in the name of Schengen. So those are some of the examples that talked about the unity in terms of European Union. The founding date remained common, and definitely there were common issues on foreign security policies that had taken place. So it had a huge economic, diplomatic, and political influence globally. EU is considered as one of the biggest economies in terms of its GDP globally, which is slightly larger than that of United States. Also, the currency euro has its importance and dominance in international world, and its share is 3 times larger than that of the American dollars, which focuses on the assertive trade disputes that are commonly seen between US and China. Also, European Union has a significant role in WTO. So it joined WTO and has a significant role in WTO. If we talk about some of the nations from European Union, Britain and France are important because they are part of the European Nations Security Council with permanent seats. Also, we do have several non-permanent members that are part of the United Nations Security Council. So those are some of the other important things. The combined armed force of European Union is second largest in the world. The spending on defense is second largest after United States, and it is also second largest in terms of space and communication technology. If we focus on countries like Denmark, the countries like Sweden, these were the countries that had resisted the Maastricht Treaty and later on the adoption of the common currency, which was euro. We also have matters of foreign trade defense, which have been very important with European Union. As we could see here, initially it was just the nations of France, parts of Germany and Italy, which were part of the European Union. But later on, Spain, Portugal, then we had the East Germany. Later on, we had the regions of Finno-Scandinavian countries, the Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, the Romania, Bulgaria region. So those were the nations that the Czech and Austria regions, the Romania, the Bulgaria and Romania areas. So those were the regions that slowly and gradually were part of the European Union. So the European Union was not established or not strengthened in one day. Slowly and gradually nations came together. There were treaties that were signed. There were European community that was built in. Greece joined as a part of the European community in 1981. And later on, we had the Schengen Agreement that was signed between these nations which are part of the European community. Formation of European Union started or took place in 1992 formally, and since then we had a single market that was created within the Europe, and that was one of the major reasons for the growth and the prosperity of European Union. And later with the Brexit, you had United Kingdoms that exited from the European Union. So there have been changes that have been seen. Now even the exit of the Brexit, as it is called, is, or the exit of Britain, is interesting because it would significantly change the food subsidies that are actually there, and how it would impact the agricultural world in long term has been very, very important. However, that would be something that we would discuss in a separate lecture. But this was about how European Union actually formed, the history behind the formation of European Union, how with US aid Marshall Plan came in, NATO was formed, and later OEEC was established. And finally, we had the European Community, the creation of European Parliament, and the European Union with a common currency as Euro and a common visa as Schengen visa, and with a single market that was laid down.